Chanel. I'm a composer and a producer. I love working with different artists and different genres.
My name is Pierre.
My name is Jonathan Tobin. Yeah, I have a small set of analog synthesizers at my house. Nothing old, but sort of the newer analogs. I got into those.
My name is Brandon, by the Wharf. I'm the founder of a record label called Wax Records. We're based out of both LA and New York.
Morgan Whirlidge. Yeah, I have a project called Chrome Canyon.
Zenya. I've used software synthesizers in the past, but they obviously aren't as good.
Max. I'm a mixer engineer. I make a mixing for musicians, for films.
My name's Rob. I'm in this band Lacoste. I work on soundscape and the stuff with my synths at home a lot.
Well, one of the issues with software that I've always had is that it's not as immediate. It's not as easy to sort of hone in on the sound that you want to get. So I like having the immediacy of all the controls, the tactile, and then I think just artistically working with an old piece of equipment or a piece of equipment with character, I think is inspiring.
I've been doing a lot of sequencing lately, like analog sequencing and playing live, and that's just kind of like, it's unbeatable, you know, it's just so fun.
The one I've heard so far that I like the most is the Juno-60. I don't know, it's just got this beefiness to it.
So I use just VSTs at home, mostly because of the Juno-60. I already had a track with a Juno-60 emulator plug-in, and I just put into the Juno and get like the big sound. It's much better, you know? Yeah.
So my experience here today at the Synth Workshop was really amazing because Nick was so helpful and patient while I was struggling with getting MIDI set up, and I really appreciated that. Just because it wasn't intimidating at all, although, being around synth-ophiles, or I don't know what the term is, it can be kind of intimidating, so that was great.
Jupiter 8, it is my impressions, my dream.
It's great, it's interesting. It's interesting to hear new sounds or hear sounds that I've heard before in songs and finally get a chance to work with them. I would absolutely consider renting a synthesizer.
Yes, I definitely rent a synthesizer, especially if I need it for a project, it makes sense than trying to, track one down or fake it with something else. It just doesn't work the same. It's easier than borrowing two from people, because then it's like, I need to borrow your synth, but renting it, it's gonna be there, ready to go.
I wanna use the Jupiter 8 for sure, because I had that VST. But I want to see how it matches up, because I know it's going to sound crazy over here.
Juno 60, which is probably my favorite, kind of like the Swiss Army knife synth.
Technology is pretty good. People are good at emulating hardware these days, but I think there's nothing compared to the tactility of having your hands on something.
I cannot compare it because first of all, it is your feelings when you touch any knob. So when you can adjust it and you feel how the amplifier works, how resistor works, so it is other feelings, and you have to try it.